It's a case study on activity-based costing. In this case study, we'll find out what is the cost as per activity-based costing. We'll also find out the cost as per traditional absorption costing. We'll try to find out the difference why that take place. Okay. ABC Limited is a multi-product company manufacturing three products A, B, and C. The budgeted cost and production for the year ending 31st March 2018 are as follows. Production quantities for three products are available. Resources per unit, direct material in kgs per unit is available. Direct labor in minutes for single unit is available. The budgeted direct labor rate was 10 per hour and budgeted material cost was 2 per kg. Production overheads were budgeted at 99,450 and were absorbed to products using direct labor hour rate, that is in the traditional absorption costing. ABC followed absorption costing system. Fine. ABC Limited is now considering to adapt to activity-based costing system. The following additional information is made available for this purpose. Budgeted overheads were analyzed. That is, this 99,450. When it was analyzed, it had three components. Material handling 29,100. So towards material handling, they should spend 29,100. Storage cost 31,200. Electricity 39,150. Let's see how it goes. The cost drivers were identified as follows. For material handling, it is weight of the material handled. Storage cost, it is the number of batches of material. Electricity, it is number of machine operations. Then data on cost drivers are available. For complete production, the batches of material are for A, B, C batches are available. And for per unit of production, the number of machine operations, not operators, operations are available. Say 632. You are requested to prepare a statement for management showing the unit cost and total cost for each product using the absorption costing method. Then prepare a statement for the management showing the product cost for each product using ABC approach. Then what are the reasons for the different product cost under two approaches? Fine. So, three products are manufactured. This is the quantity that is manufactured. And for producing single unit, they want 4, 6 and 3 kgs of materials. And for producing single unit, this is the time taken in minutes. And this 99,450 is the overhead. That is the topic now. This 99,450 have to be distributed amongst these three products. They followed absorption costing system. So in absorption costing system, they are going to divide this 99,450 using direct labor hour rate. So we should know how many labor hours are consumed. We know how many labor hours are required for producing each and every unit. That multiplied by total number of units, okay, it will give us what is the total time taken. And if that is divided by this 99,450, we will know what is the recovery rate. Okay, so let's have a working note 1. Working note 1, under traditional absorption costing, let us find out the number of labor hours. Number of labor hours, it's going to be simple. So we'll have a table like this, particulars, product A, B, C, and we'll also have a column for total. So production quantity, which we can pick up from the question here we have, this is the production quantity, 4,000, 3,000, 1,600. Okay, so these many units are produced. And what is the direct labor hour per unit that we can pick up from the question? For producing one unit, 30 minutes, 45 minutes, 60 minutes. Okay, 30 minutes is nothing but 0.5 hour. 45 minutes means 3/4 hour. 60 minutes is 1 hour. So here for product A, 4,000 units are produced and direct labor per unit is 30 minutes. This is in minutes. So I want to know what is the total labor hour required for producing all the 4,000 units. So for that I can find out like this. Total labor hours required is nothing but A into B divided by 60 minutes. What is that? For producing one unit, 30 minutes are required. Okay, then for producing 4,000 units, how many minutes are required? We'll be getting some number. But if I want to express that, if I want to express that in hours, I should divide it by 60. Simple. So 4,000 multiplied by 30, I'll be getting some number, say 12,000. Okay, that is 12,000 minutes are required, and if I divide it by 60, I get 2,000 hours. Same is the case here. 3,000 into 45. Okay, look at the calculation. 3,000 multiplied by 45, you have D5 into D6. Whatever the number, divided by 60, you get 2,250 hours. Same here for C, we get 1,600 into 60 divided by 60. Okay, we get 1,600 hours, or we can simply say 1,600 hours, because for each and every unit they are taking 60 minutes, they are producing 1,600 units, so it will take 1,600 hours. Fine. So now if you can total all the three, you will know what is the total labor hour required for producing all the three units, and that's what you have here, which is 5,850. Right. Now finding the overhead rate per labor hour is very simple, because already we know what is the overhead cost, which is 99,450. Now we know what is the total hours. So let's have a working note too. That is overhead rate per labor hour. That is, we know what is the production overhead cost, 99,450. Number of labor hours, just now we have calculated 5,850. Capturing it here, so 99,450 divided by 5,850 will give you overhead rate per labor hour, which is 17. Okay, for 1 hour, the overhead rate that should be recovered is 17, and this 1 hour is expressed as labor hours. Okay, right. So now we know what is the overhead rate per labor hour. Then I think finding the production overhead cost is going to be very simple now. We'll have working note 3. Working note 3, production overhead rate per unit. So what we have understood is this production overheads should be recovered on the basis of direct labor hour. And what we have calculated now, overhead rate per labor hour is 17. Okay, fine. Now we should know what is the time taken, what is the direct labor hours taken for each and every product. That's what we are capturing here. We have three products, and what we understand is production overhead rate per labor hour is 17. We have calculated now. This 17 is per hour, right? So this should be multiplied with the number of hours taken for producing each and every product. If you take product A, the direct labor hour per unit in minutes, what we have in the question is 30 minutes, 45 minutes, 60 minutes, right? So we'll capture that 30, 45, 60. Fine. This 17 is for 1 hour, but product A is taking only 30 minutes. So if you want to find out the cost for 30 minutes, it's simple. We can say production overhead per unit is nothing but this 17 is for 1 hour. So 17 divided by 60, A divided by 60 multiplied by B. And that will give us 8.5. okay, so basically half of it. And for 45 minutes, 17 divided by 60 multiplied by 45, we get 12.75. and here obviously 17 divided by 60 into 60, you are going to get this 17. Okay, so now we have production overhead rate per unit also. Let's go to working note 4, where we will find out what is the total cost per unit and the total cost also as per absorption costing. So we have to record the cost per unit for raw material, we have to record cost per unit for say labor and overheads. So let's have this table, particulars A, B, C. Item number A, let's capture direct material cost. So how we are going to capture the direct material cost? Let's go back to the question. Question says 4 kgs of material is required for producing 1 unit. And what is the material cost? It is 2 per kg. So 4 multiplied by 2, 8 is the cost, right? So let's see. Yes, here we have 4 multiplied by 2, 8 rupees is the material cost per unit. Fine. Similarly, what we have for B and C, it is 6 kgs and 3 kgs. So 6 into 2, 3 into 2. That's it. So we'll capture that here. 6 into 2, 12. 3 into 2, 6. So this is direct material cost. What about direct labor cost? Question says direct labor cost is rupees 10 per hour. and here it is 30 minutes, so half hour, 10 into 30 by 60, so it's going to be 5, and here it's going to be different, here it's going to be different, here it's going to be same 10. So let's capture that here. Direct labor cost is nothing but labor hours per unit into 10 per hour. So here if you look at the calculation, it was 30 minutes, right? So 30 minutes, we know 10 rupees is for 60 minutes. So 30 divided by 60 multiplied by 10, we get 5. And here it is 45 minutes. 45 by 60 multiplied by 10, we get 7.5. And here it is 60 minutes itself. So the 10 rupees itself will come into picture. Then comes the production overhead cost per unit, which we have calculated in working note 3. So these three numbers should come over here, right? So now, if we can sum all the three, we can get total cost per unit, right? So here we have the total cost per unit. Fine. Now, if we can multiply this with number of units, this information is available in the question, 4000, 3000, 1600, we get to know what is the total cost under traditional absorption costing method. Okay, so under traditional absorption costing method, the total cost per unit is 21.5 for A, 32.25 for B, and 33 for C, and this is the total amount. Fine. Now, let's move on to the other method, that is, we are going to find out the total cost as per ABC system. Let me go back to the question once again. What we have understood is the total production overheads budgeted is 99,450, and it is actually incurred for three purposes: material handling, storage cost, electricity. That is, in material handling, we have to spend 29,100. Why we are spending 29,100 on material handling? Because so much of weights of material are handled. So we cannot say that this 29,100 should be distributed on the basis of direct labor hours, because the materials that are handled in each and every product are different. Because if you look at product A, they are producing 4,000 units. Product B, 3,000. Product C, it is only 1,600. And if you look at the kgs in proportion, for product A, it is 4,000 into 4, 16,000 kgs. For product B, it is 3,000 into 6, 18,000 kgs. And product C, it's very, very lesser, because it's only 1,600 into 3. So you cannot simply distribute that material handling cost, or you should not distribute that material handling cost on the basis of direct labor hours, because the treatment, the handling is much, much higher in department B. So much of the cost should go to department B, and least cost should go to department C. I'm sorry, not department, it's product. It's product B and product C. Okay, that's where activity-based costing comes into picture, and it gives even a better clarity. So we'll have this working note 5. We'll have this working note 5 where we will find out what are the cost drivers. For that, if you read once again here, the cost drivers are the material handling, these are all the activities: material handling, storage cost, electricity. These are all the activities, and the cost drivers are: for material handling, it is weight of material handled. For storage cost, it is nothing but the number of batches of material. And for electricity, it is number of machine operations. So all these have to be factored. All these have to be factored. For that, we'll have this working note 5, that is cost drivers. First, let's focus on weight, because material handling is with regard to the weight of material handled. Fine. Now we'll have this table, particulars column ABC, and we'll also have a column for total. First of all, let's capture the quantity produced for each and every product. Product A, it is 4000 given in question. Product B, 3000. Product C, 1600. And what we understand is, for producing product A, raw material required is 4 kgs for one unit. For product B, 6 kgs for producing one unit. And for product C, 3 kgs are required. It means for producing product A, 4000 into 4, 16,000 kgs are required. Product B, 3000 into 6, 18. And product C, 1600 into 3, 4800 kgs. It means these much of material in kgs are handled. So total material handled in kgs itself is 38,800. It's for this 38,800 kgs this cost is incurred, that is 29,100. So we should find out what is the material handling cost per kg. That's where this working note is going to help us, because what we have understood is the total material in cages handled is 38,800, but the total material handling cost is 29,100. So let's capture here, total material handling cost is 29,100, total weights handled is 38,800. If 29,100 is incurred for 38,800, so what is the material handling cost per kg? It's simple, item number 1 by 2, we get 0.75 per kg. This is 0.75 per kg. So for handling each and every kg, the cost incurred is 0.75. So now we can simply multiply this 0.75 with the 16,000, 18,000, 4,800 to find out material handling cost attributable to product ABC. That's the beauty of activity-based costing. Okay, this is about weights. Then we have the second activity, that's storage cost. The third activity is electricity. Now, with regard to storage cost, the information what we have in the question is the number of batches. So there are 10, 5, 15 batches, and it's for these three, say 10, 5, 15 plus 15, 30. It's for this 30 batches, this storage cost of 31,200 have been incurred. So that should also be distributed. So we'll capture that here. We'll have a similar table, particulars, ABC total. The number of batches are 10 batches for A, 5 batches for B, and 15 batches for C. So there are totally 30 batches. So we know the total storage cost from the question is 31,200. The number of batches what we have derived now is 30. It means storage cost per batch is 31,200 divided by 30. It is 1040. Now how this will help? Yes, it is going to help us in distributing this storage cost of 31,200 over three different products. But this 1040 is in terms of batch. Let's not worry, no, because we can reduce the batches into number of units also. That you will see how we are going to do it. Okay. Then the third activity was, is it electricity? Yes, 39,150 spent, and the driver is number of machine operations. So let's find out how many operations are required for producing one unit of A, 6 operations. For B, it is 3, and for C, it is 2. For producing one unit, how many units are produced? Units produced are 4,000, 3,000, 1,600. So easily, we can find out the total operations, which is nothing but A into B, 6 into 4,000, it's 24,000, 3 into 3,000, 9,000, 2 into 1,600, it's 3,200. So the total number of operations is sum of all the three, which is 36,200. It is for this 36,200, the amount of 39,150 is spent. So let's capture that here. Total electricity cost is 39,150. The number of machine operations is 36,200. So we can find out what is the electricity rate per operation, which is 1.08, nothing but 39,150 divided by 36,200. So now we have electricity rate per operation. So we got what is the rate per unit, or say per batch or per kg for each and every item. We'll go ahead and find out what is going to be the production overhead cost when you do it under activity-based costing. That's very critical. Let's do it now. So what we understand is this production overheads has three components. One is material handling, the other one is storage cost, and third one is electricity. Okay. Now let's find out what is going to be the material handling cost per unit. See, we know what is the material consumed in kgs for each and every unit. It was available in question. For product A, it is 4 kgs, B, 6 kgs, and C, it is 3 kgs. Now it's going to be simple. We know what is the material consumed per unit, which is 4, 6, and 3. If that material consumed in kgs can be multiplied with material handling rate, what we have derived here, it is 0.75, okay? We get to know what is the material handling cost per unit. because for each and every unit 4, 6 and 3 kgs are required. This is the cost per kg. If we can multiply this, this is going to be the material handling cost per unit for A, 3, 4.5 for B and 2.25 for C. Okay, only this should go to A, B and C. Similarly, let us also talk about storage cost. See, storage cost is very important because here the calculation is slightly different. It is linked with the batches. Okay, and what we have understood is storage cost is 31,200 and it is linked with the number of batches. But how we are going to continue this? Look at this. What is the quantity produced? 4,000, 3,000, 1,600 for ABC. How many batches they are going to have? This information was available in the question. The batches are 10, 5 and 15. Right. Let's capture. 10, 5 and 15. But this is the number of units. So, this is the quantity produced. This is number of batches. If you can divide the quantity produced by number of batches, you will get to know how many units are there in each and every batch. For A, it's 4,000 by 10, 400. For B, it's 3,000 by 5, 600. And for C, it's 1,600 by 15. It is 106.67. Fine. So now what we have is how many units are there in the batch. Already, we have calculated what is going to be the cost per batch. Is it not? Yes. Here we have calculated what is going to be the storage cost per batch. And here we have how many units are in single batch. So, you know the storage cost per batch. You also know number of units in a batch. So, storage cost divided by number of units in a batch will give you storage cost per unit. Right? So, let's capture the storage cost. It's nothing but the 1040 which we have calculated. And here you have the number of units per batch. So storage cost per unit is nothing but storage cost per batch, which is item number 4, divided by number of units in a batch. So it's 1040 divided by 400, 2.6. 1040 divided by 600, 1.73. And 1040 divided by the above number, which is 9.75. So in this way, we got the storage cost per unit also. That goes into the production overhead cost. Then the third one, we should find out what is the electricity cost per unit also, right? Because what we understand is electricity cost is 39,150 and the drivers are the number of operations which we have already calculated. If you look at here, we have calculated the number of operations and we concluded electricity rate per operation is 1.08. And we know how many operations are required. The number of operations are 632. Okay, so let's look at this. That is electricity cost per unit. The number of operations required per unit is 6, 3 and 2 for product ABC. Already we have calculated what is the electricity rate per operation, which is 1.08. If we can multiply that, we will get to know what is the electricity cost per unit. So it is 6.49, 3.24 and 2.16. So in this way, we have calculated the cost per unit for each and every activity, that is material handling, storage cost, electricity cost. So we'll consolidate all the three here. Production overhead cost per unit, material handling cost, what we have already calculated, storage cost, electricity cost. So if we can total all those, we get 12.09. 9.48 and 14.16. Okay, now let us have this working note. Working note 7, we are going to find out the unit cost and total cost under activity based costing. Absolutely, we don't have any issues in the direct material cost and direct labor cost. This is going to be as same as what we did under traditional absorption costing. The difference is with regard to the production overhead cost per unit, which is what we have calculated now. That is this 12.09, 9.48 and 14.16. We have all those. So if we can total this, right, we get our total cost per unit. And if we can multiply that with the number of units, that's 4,000, 3,000, 1,600, we get the total cost, which is 1,355,000. 86933.43 and 48260.77. This is the total cost under activity-based costing. Now let me show you the difference between the cost under ABC and traditional absorption. So here we have the difference between cost in traditional absorption and activity-based. So this is the cost under absorption costing per unit. 21.5, 32.25, 33 for product ABC. Now for the same product under ABC, that is activity-based costing, for product A the cost has increased to 25.09 from 21.9, whereas the cost for product B and C has come down from 32.25, 33 to 28.98 and 30.16. And this is the overall effect. Okay, this is per unit effect, this is overall effect. Let me also show you the line by line difference. Okay, this is the component. We had direct material cost, direct labor, production. In traditional, this is the structure. 8 is the material cost, labor is 5, production overhead is 8.5. And here in ABC, if you notice, the material and labor cost are one and the same. The issue is here. In the place of 8.5, what you have now is 12.09. Similarly, for product B and C, you don't have any issue with the material cost and labor cost, but the issue is in the overheads, right? If you take product B, in traditional, the overhead absorbed is 12.75, whereas activity-based costing, it is only 9.48. For product C, in traditional, it was 17, whereas ABC says it's only 14.16. So if you notice, in traditional, the cost of product A per unit was 21.5, whereas ABC says it is 25.09. For product B, it has come down from 32.25 to 28.98. And for product C also, it has come down from 33 to 30.16. Okay, so you can see substantial difference in terms of cost. Okay, so what we have to understand is the difference in cost, or difference in cost per unit or total cost, is due to difference in overheads borne by each products. And this ABC is more precise than the traditional absorption costing.